First, your father died. And now your sister is missing, too.
Mother, don't worry too much about it. I made a promise to Father that I will make sure our family will always be intact. I will not stop until I find Mayumi.
What did you say? You are Virgie's daughter? You're my granddaughter?
Yes. I came all the way from the province. Madame Rosa came to see my mother. She said that you were looking for me. And that's the reason why I came here.
Does your mother know you're here?
Not really. She doesn't want to give me away. That's why I left home. I want to know who you are, and I wanted to know who my real father is.
What is this? Who is that child? Could somebody please tell me what's going on?
Eleanor, let's step outside
Mother!
And talk. I said let us talk outside. That girl is my granddaughter.
What? How did that happen?
9 years ago, before you and Sigmund were married, he slept with a woman. Virgie, that was her name. She was a waitress from the province, in one of those nightclubs. When I learned about Sigmund's indiscretion, I immediately forbade him to ever see that woman. I ordered him to marry you instead. We never knew that a child was born. And she is that child.
You people tricked me. You made me look like a fool.
We never lied, Eleanor. We never thought that Virgie will bear a child.
Well then, Mother, I want you to throw that child out.
Why would I do such a thing? Remember that she is my own flesh and blood.
What are you trying to tell me, Mother? You have this girl live here in the house?
You can't bear a child. And I want a grandchild. She is already here. I will gladly acknowledge her.
No, I won't agree to this, Mother.
I don't think you have a choice, honey. For as long as you are living under my roof, you will follow my every command. And so, you will accept that child, my granddaughter. Eleanor, you will treat her as your own. You will be nice to her and regard her well. And if you cannot carry out what I ask, you are by all means free to leave and walk out the door.
Good morning, Chief.
Hi, Chief.
Chief.
So,
Chief.
What are you doing here again?
What's going on here? But
what crime have you committed, huh?
Wait, one second.
Come on. Why are you so angry, Chief, huh? Why do you act like you're allergic to us?
We have received a number of complaints filed against you. I wouldn't be surprised if you've committed a crime.
Well, I'm just looking for my sister.
Your sister?
Uh-huh.
What's the name of your sister?
It's Mayumi Burgos. She's my twin sister.
When did she go missing? When did you last see her?
It was just the other day, at my father's funeral.
Ah, how old is she?
She's 9 years old.
The way I see it, there's not much chance of her getting lost, unless she was kidnapped.
Well, we don't have any money. Why would anyone kidnap her?
Maybe she left on purpose. Is there any reason for her to leave home? You do know, it's hard to look for someone who doesn't want to be found.
She has no reason to leave home at all.
Okay, then. I will file a report.
Thanks so
much.
Oh,
thank you.
Okay. Thanks,
thank
Chief.
You so much.
I wonder where Mayumi could
be. I'm sure they'll find her.
They'll find her.
It's nice, right?
Oh, yes.
Very nice.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Mother? Habagat? Have you eaten yet? Not yet? Oh, you poor boy. Just a second, okay? Come here. Just sit down. Be quiet, huh? We don't want to wake Mother up.
Oh, hey, Nanny. Where's my juice?
Okay, just a minute.
And you, Nanny? Please get my doll, too.
Hi, honey.
Hi, Father.
Mwah. Something for you.
Thank you.
Oh, wow. I bought these all for you.
Oh, really? Thank you.
Do you like them?
Oh, what? Yes, I really love it all.
Are you happy here, Mayumi?
Oh, yes, Father. Very much.
Look here, it's so big,
That's true. It's almost as tall as me.
Walks, you know.
Nanny, could you look at that? The pool looks so dirty. How could I swim in that? Maybe I should push you in there instead, huh? What do you expect? You never clean up the pool. It's so dirty, I can't go swimming.
Oh,
clean
yes.
now. Or do you want me to make you swim in that?
No!
Do you want that, huh? You are all just so irritating. Oh, hi, Mother. It's all their fault. They don't want to clean the pool.
Go to the kitchen and stay there. Don't you ever call me Mother again. You don't belong in this house. Go back to wherever province you came from. Back to your poor old mother. You don't belong here.
Do you really want me to go back to my old home?
Oh, yes.
Are you sure? If I go back to my old home, I know Father will follow me there. He and my mother might see each other again. And there's a chance that they would like each other again. I mean, her husband just died, you know. Then he could be my father again. And at least we'll finally have a complete family.
Oh, you pesky little brat.
But I don't want to go back there. I'd like to stay here. And really, I would rather have you as my mother. I think you are just so beautiful. You look young like a teenager. We can look like sisters. Your skin is perfect, like an actress. It just looks so smooth, and you act so young. I really wish that you were my real mother. Just you, and me, and my father.
Oh, Myrna!
Ning, why, what is it?
Is it okay if I leave Habagat with you? Just for a while. I will just see if I can get some fish at the port.
Come here and have a seat. Come
is something wrong? Habagat.
Have you eaten your breakfast?
It's all right. I'm really just in a hurry.
Ning, you're a child. Just remember that. It's your mother's responsibility.
It's just that I made a promise to my father.
Aren't you having a hard time?
Yes, it's hard. But I just don't think about it. I really love them. I need to take care of them.
Oh, dear Maningning. Look at your sister. She's working for you. Be careful, okay?
Habagat, stay there and just be safe, okay? I'm just marinating the fish. Don't hurt yourself playing.
Maningning?
Yes?
Keep an eye on your brother for a while, okay? I'm going out for a bit to get some work done.
Oh, really, Mother?
Of course. Well, you see, it's different now. Your father passed away. And we have to go on with our lives. To survive, I will have to find other means to earn a living.
But then, what about Mayumi? We still haven't found her.
I am just hoping that someday she will find a way back home, and I have faith that time will come. She will come back to us. And when that happens, our family will be complete again.
Mother.
Who's there?
It's Virgie.
Go on, let her in.
Who's the boss?
That's him. You, the new collector?
I'm Virgie.
Have a seat. Do you know anything about the job you want?
It's just messed up.
Your new area will be the pier. Do you know every corner of that place?
Even with my eyes closed.
You will collect all the people's bets.
Yes.
And then you will hand it over to me.
Is that it?
You look poor.
You're aware that this is illegal, right? You shouldn't be caught by the police.
So?
You should be able to run fast, and you should know how to get rid of the evidence you have quickly. If you can do that, the job is yours.
So, when can I start working?
Next time, they have to pay.
Hey! Arlen! What are you doing here? Why are you all alone? Where are the others?
Oh, I don't know.
What? Did you guys get in a fight? Did they pick on you? You want me to scold them?
Don't bother, Ning. They might start ignoring me if you do.
Keep their distance? How can you say that?
Well, there are times they don't want me to come along. Really, I know why. Because they'll do something bad. But what can I do if I don't like doing that? I don't want to do bad things. But then, Ma Ning Ning, I also don't want to lose my friends. Do you think that I should just go along? So that I'll fit in?
Oh, Noraman, you shouldn't do anything bad. If you're a real friend, you should not let them turn into bad people. Promise me this, that whatever happens, you will try and help me keep them straight and good. Don't allow them to be criminals, okay?
Promise, Ma Ning Ning. Thanks a lot, okay?
Okay, come on. Let me help you sell your ice candies.
There. Eat all of them. You should eat lots of fresh fruits so that you'll maintain that youthful look.
Oh, just like yours, Mother?
There. You should not even touch your face without washing your hands first, little girl.
Ah. Okay, then.
Mayumi? Mayumi, honey.
Oh, hello.
You're just here. Do you want to live abroad?
Oh, yes, I want to go.
Mother and I have agreed that we should all go live abroad. We might even have better lives there.
Hooray!
And, my dear, when we finally leave this place, you will have to forget all that you remember of your past, do you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
And you will have no other family but us.
Also, maybe we should change your last name, too. From now on, you will be a Portiera. Do you like that?
Uh-huh. Yes, I like that. If we do that, can you also change my name? I don't like my name, Mayumi. It sounds old.
Oh, my little girl, of course you can. What name do you want? Cinderella? Snow White? Or Rapunzel?
Father, I ask forgiveness from you. I couldn't keep the promise I made to you. I looked everywhere, but I can't find Mayumi. I have no idea where she is. Or even why she ran away. Father, please help me in my search for her. I assure you that I will not stop until I find my twin sister.
Ning Ning,
oh, Mother.
I have roasted chicken.
Oh? Really? We're going to eat roasted chicken?
Yes. Set the table. I'm so hungry already.
All right.
I got paid good tonight, Ma Ning Ning.
Mother, what job did you get?
It doesn't matter. What's important is that we have some money and you'll be able to go to school.
Oh, will Habagat also go to school?
Maybe in the future. I want for you, Ma Ning Ning, to get a nursing course. And then you'll go abroad, okay? After that, you will be able to give us a better life. So promise me this, that you will study really hard.
Yes, Mother!
It's you again.
Chief, please, can you forgive me?
So where's your lawyer?
I don't have one.
That's why you're up to no good again. You don't have that big sister of yours to stop you.
Boss, please have mercy on me. I don't want to go to jail.
You can explain at the precinct. Let's go. Arrest him.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay. Okay.
Let's
go. Okay. Let's do this. Let's
go. Please don't, sir. Please.
Come with me.
You're too young to go to jail.
No. Come with me.
Hello, officer. We are here for Conrad Okoy. We'd like to bail him out.
Oh, he's on his way.
Thank you so much.
Excuse me. Here's your son.
My goodness. What happened to you?
Ouch!
Stop whining. Don't make such a fuss. All this is your fault.
What? What happened to you?
It's nothing. The police wanted to teach me a lesson. They beat me up a bit. That's why I'm like this.
Serves you right. They caught him sniffing solvent.
Ouch!
Even tried to escape, but he was caught. Now you stop whining there.
If you want, I can really beat you up too.
No way. This hurts already.
Of course it will hurt. Didn't I tell you that you should not do anything bad? But you guys never listened to me. Look at that.
I'm sorry, Ming Ning. Please don't be mad at me. I know I broke my promise to you. But then, please believe me. It's the last time. I won't do it again.
Ning, will it be okay if you take over this? I still have to deliver all the laundry.
All right.
Oh, here it is. This is the medicine. Just add more ointment. Oh, what a naughty boy.
You just don't listen, Bukol. Mother?
Where have you been?
I just came from Myrna's place.
Do you even know how worried I have been? I've been waiting for you for hours.
I'm sorry about that.
What do you mean, sorry? Do you know I spent the entire day worrying, thinking that maybe you could have left me just like your good-for-nothing twin sister, huh? Didn't you even think of that?
Mother, I can never do that to you, you know.
You bet you won't. You can't do that to me, because if you do that, I'll beat you until you bleed. Do you understand that? You won't be able to leave this house ever. Get that through your thick skull.
Yes, Mother.
Ning Ning.
Ning Ning.
Ning
Ning. Is she there? Ning, are you
there?
Why
don't we take a look there? She might be there.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Hello, Virgie. Is Ning Ning there?
Yes, she's here. But then I have forbidden her to go out starting today. I don't want her to become stupid kids like you. So you better get lost now.
You sound like an old hag, Virgie.
Come on.
What did you say?
Old hag.
Old hag, huh?
Oh, no.
You boys get lost now. Get lost. Run off. And don't you ever come back, huh?
Old hag.
Just go to bed.
Muerte, they're calling you. You're a free man.
Hey, man, you'll be free. Why not take us with you, huh? Come on, get up. You're a free man. Hey, what are you doing there?
Freeze, don't move.
Harold Muerte,
Judging by the merits of your case, this honorable court finds you guilty. You are sentenced to reclusion perpetua, or 25 up to 40 years of imprisonment.
What? Boss, this is a mistake, boss. Wait, this wasn't part of our deal. This is a mistake, help me!
I don't like Father.
And when did you start talking back? You better come back here. I said come back here.
Stop
now.
Stop or I'll call 911.
Go ahead, call them all you want, but I won't let you grow up into a brat.
I hate you, I hate you, stop it! I don't like you anymore! I hate you, let me go!
Alright, I can take you back to that stinking place where you used to live in. Huh?
What's this? Hey, stop that, Sigmund, stop it!
That's why she's growing up to be a pain, you're siding with her!
She's your daughter, why are you hurting her?
You two are alike, you deserve each other.
What is this? Come on.
Dear Ningning, I miss you so much. I wonder when I'll see you again. When can we play? Your mother is so irritating. She won't allow you to go out. But then don't worry. I'll always send you a letter. Just take good care of yourself, okay? Always eat well. Don't let yourself go hungry. All right? Until my next letter. Love, Eric.
You know what? Why don't you just come and get me? I'm right here.
Come on. Show me what you got.
You're all caught. I told you, stop it.
What?
Come on, guys.
Stop that.
What?
Show me what you got.
Don't do this.
Come on.
Let me at him.
Hold it. What's happening here? Huh? What's happening here?
It's his fault.
It's his fault, huh? Go on, settle this. Shake hands and settle this.
I don't want to.
Go on.
No, you don't want to?
Buko.
Come on.
Go on, shake hands. I don't want to. He started it.
Show off.
Oh, don't you start with me. I told you guys to settle this. Both will be my enemies.
Come on, shake hands.
Knock both your heads together. So settle this. Do it.
Sam, sorry. Jeez. There we go.
There now. I want you to stay that way, okay? Now, come on. Let's go.
Nice one, Buko. I won there. Woohoo.
Hey, you too.
Oh, thank you.
Ning, I don't like you now. I know that you choose to side with that octopus all the time. You always pick on me.
What are you saying? She doesn't side with me. She just slapped you. She punched me.
She didn't punch you. I saw you earlier. You were just pinched. I was the one who was punched.
Wait.
I'll show you a punch. Why don't you come over here?
Come on. You'll end up fighting over nothing. Why can't you both see? I love you both equally, okay? That's why I don't want us to argue with each other. I want our friendship to be solid.
That's right, solid. Solid punch.
But Ningning loves you equally, but she loves me much more than you guys, right?
Eric, stop that. Ever since we were kids, that has always been your line. We're older already, and that's still it?
What do you expect? Ningning was still 9 when you stalked your claim on her.
I had no choice. She has lowlifes like you around her all the time. I was just making sure she's mine.
Eric, you stop it with that. That's enough. You know, you're all like brothers and sisters, so you shouldn't be fighting. It should be one for all and all for one, okay?
Now what? Come on, eat.
You and Octopus should stop that. Hey.
We're okay now. We're cool already. I'm just saying that he really started the argument. We all know that he really started it.
My headache.
What's going on here?
Take a look at that.
You're giving me a headache.
He has a scary bonnet there.
All right, that's enough. Come on. Come on, Abagget.
Great girls.
Look for some really pretty girls like your
sister. Come on, let's go.
Hey, Fat Chance.
Let's go, dude.
I'm one of a kind.
She is. You bet she is.
Hey, guys.
Here we are again.
Hey, Virgie. How are you?
Keep going.
Doing well.
Oh, that looks good.
So what's your bet?
Thank you very much. I like what I do.
Come back later. I don't have any money yet.
My fish.
Okay, fine. I'll come back for your bets later, okay?
Out before the sun comes up.
Help me out here, guys. What do you have there?
Hey,
Virgie.
What's
your bet?
How are your kids doing?
They're just fine.
Good.
Well, my Ningning, She's almost finished with her nursing course.
Did I hear you say she's almost a nurse?
That's funny.
That's funny, huh?
You shouldn't be laughing at that. She will eventually be a nurse, you know? And when that time comes, when my daughter works abroad, I will no longer need your money that smells like rotten fish.
Fish stench.
Look at her.
You are all idiots.
Fish
let me tell, for what number?
Just 5 and 6.
So okay,
Virgie.
5 and 6.
Can we call you Madame Virgie then?
Oh, how I wish. 5 and 6. How much is your bet?
Just 10.
We need to collect more fish.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
And you, won't you guys place a bet the last time you won, right?
I think we should take this out already.
Mm-hmm, okay. Over here.
What now? No one else?
No,
you won't place
here.
A bet?
We'll work first.
No thank you. No thanks.
Here.
Okay.
Oh, gotta keep working on this.
Gotta keep busy. Yeah.
Keep dividing it up, guys.
Ning Ning.
Yes.
Ning, your allowance.
Oh, thank you, Mother.
Mm-hmm. Ning Ning.
Yes.
When are you graduating again, huh? When?
Mother, I just have one more year to go.
One more year? Why does it seem so long? Are you repeating some of your subjects, huh?
No. Mother, no. I'm studying really hard.
Okay, just do your best. Because we need you to help us out. Me and Habagat, okay?
Okay.
So, why aren't you getting ready for school? Get a move on it. You shouldn't run late for your class.
Oh, Mother, it's okay. I'll just finish scrubbing this, then I'll leave for school.
Just make sure you do, huh?
Are you listening to what I'm saying?
Yes.
Forget girls.
Yes.
Concentrate in your studies.
Yes.
You and your friends are all the same.
Here I am, here I am.
Hey, got something for me?
Okay, there, there. Just study hard, all right? What's so funny?
Well, you sound so much like Mother. The difference is, I'm studying. And you're not.
I know, my conscience is bothering me. It's been 4 years that we've lied to Mother about me studying.
Until when do you think can we keep this up, Ning Ning?
I don't know. Just make sure that you will do good with your studies. Keep in mind the sacrifice I'm making is for your future.
You're just like Mother.
Okay, then, you better go. Go on to school. Move it,
okay,
move it. I still
okay,
have to hurry
Ning
to the fish port.
Okay,
hey, do your
care.
Best, okay? Have you seen my boots here?
It's just here. You left it there.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
Do you have any idea about the kind of job you're getting yourselves into?
Not yet.
We will earn truckloads of money from this type of business, okay? All you have to do is chat with foreigners through the computer. And then, if they request you to do something, you'll just do it. Whatever it is.
Sure.
Okay. But before that, you will tell them to send over some money. They will send the money to this account, all right?
Okay.
Okay, then we will inform you if the money was deposited. Only then can you grant their requests, okay?
Okay. Let's just keep this quiet. It's our little secret, okay? We will earn loads of money. But if we're caught, we'll all go to jail. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Over here, miss. Over here. Here's your fish.
Ning Ning. Ning Ning. Hey!
Hey! Hi, Mon! My goodness,
how are
you're so
you?
Tall!
Hey,
and you're
ouch.
Looking really good, huh?
Stop
oh,
teasing.
Wow, is it really you?
Huh?
When did you get here?
Oh, I just arrived today. We don't have classes. It's our school break.
Oh, good for you.
How are you?
You're looking really good now.
How are you? Thank you,
that's
thank you.
That's great. So tell me, Armin, do you have a girlfriend in the city?
No, no one. No girl has made that mistake yet, Ning Ning.
No one has made a mistake.
Not really.
You know, you really should stop lying. With your looks, plus you're a good man and still no girlfriend?
Ning Ning, come on, believe me. There's a lot of good-looking men in the city.
Very cheap. Oh, and by the way, were you able to ask about Miyumi? I'm getting
tired of this. Well, that's the thing, Ning Ning. That's why I passed by. I went to look for any trace of her from the police. I even asked a friend of mine there. I had him help me in my search. I'm just wondering why. There's no record of Miyumi anywhere. I found nothing about Miyumi Burgos.
Are you sure?
Yes, nothing. I don't really know what happened. I just can't find anything.
She's been missing for 14 years. And until now, we still haven't seen any trace of her. Maybe she really doesn't want to be found.
Help me, help me, okay?
Well, you know, I just hope that she's doing really well.
Okay.
So, what now? What do you want to eat? For our lunch? This one? Or this?
That one looks good.
This one? How do you want it cooked?
In vinegar.
Of course, that's your favorite.
Come get in, my princess. Oh, what a pretty, pretty sight.
Yeah,
put your
right.
bag there.
Daphne, where the hell have you been? I've been looking all over the place for you.
Ladies' room. Charles, when are we getting married?
Right. Mister, are we anywhere near yet?
Just a few more miles, sir.
Oh my gosh. I love your house.
Well, thank you.
Charles!
Mother!
Oh, hurry up,
Charles!
Madam. Sir Charles is here.
Charles!
Oh, here he is.
Charles!
My baby boy.
Hi. You act like you haven't seen me in ages, Mother.
You're still my baby, my one and only.
Your baby boy already knows how to make babies now.
Who is she?
Oh, that's Daphne, my classmate from abroad.
Hi, Mother. Hello. It's nice to meet you.
Charles, can I talk to you?
Yes, sure.
Excuse me, miss.
What's wrong?
Is that girl your wife?
What? Mother, of course not.
Then who is she?
Let's just say she's my favorite pastime.
You're so naughty. As long as it's not serious, huh? That's all fine by me.
Mother.
I really don't like her. She's cheap.
You don't have to worry about anything because the woman who will drive me madly in love, she has not been born yet. So you really shouldn't worry about
it. Boy. I miss you too.
So, Maningning, where do you want to go?
How about your place?
My place again? Why don't we eat out? It'll be nice to go to the town.
What are you thinking? You know that I can't go to town with you, right? What if someone sees us together? Mother knows a lot of people, you know. She can even run for mayor and still win.
Let's just tell her about our relationship. We've been together a long time, but we're still hiding it from people.
Why? How long have we been together?
Okay, let me see. If I remember right, I was 9 years old. I started proposing to you.
Oh, really?
And then we got together when you turned 18. So, now that you're 23, nothing has changed. We're still hiding our relationship. You know, why don't we just elope? We're of legal age anyway,
stop
right?
Stop that. That's all nonsense, Eric, okay? You know that I can't do that, right? You remember, don't you?
I know, you? I know.
I promised my father.
You promised him that you'll take care of your family.
Hmm.
Okay, then. Let's just watch a movie.
All right.
Great,
let's go.
Come on.
Here you go. Come in.
Who's our new boss?
I am. Who's asking? How are you doing, Virgie?
Just give this to him.
Wait. Where are you going? Aren't you happy to see me at all?
I don't want to see anyone who's connected with that animal, Sigmund.
Don't be upset. I haven't seen that trail in a while. Since I went to jail because of his betrayal. I never thought we would meet again. And as one of my collectors.
I have to go. I have a lot of bets to collect.
Okay. You take care.
Go, Charles!
Wow, that's really good. Oh, look at that.
Good stuff.
All right.
Charles, you've really improved with your capoeira. Oh, dear, you're all hot and sweaty, huh?
Thanks. Oh, Daphne, my friends and I will have a drink later.
Can I go with you?
You can have me.
Well, it's a boys' night out.
But it's all right if I join you, right?
Why don't you just go home?
To your house?
Oh, no, to your own house in the city, right?
What are you doing tonight?
But wait, I thought I would spend my vacation here at your place.
Look, you assumed. I still have a lot of things to do, and I won't be able to entertain you. So if you don't mind, I'll have the driver take you straight home, all right? Boys, let's do it. Just one more time.
I wish this day could go on forever.
Why so?
Oh, nothing. I just feel that whenever we part, that's it. We'll never see each other again.
Huh? Why do you feel that?
Maybe because I know that if we're forced to choose, you will always choose your family. That's totally fine. Except that what will happen to me? Where will I go then?
Hey, come on. Please, you shouldn't think that way. You should always remember, whatever happens, that I love you.
Really?
Mm-hmm. How about me? Do you love me?
Oh, no.
Why not?
I don't just love you. I love you very much.
Oh, that line was off the charts in cheesiness.
Where have you been? I had you picked up at the airport.
I was at my boyfriend's place.
So you go off with a guy without first saying hello to your own family?
Family? The only one who treats me like real family in this house is Mother. And the irony of that is, we are not even blood related.
Maybe you'd like me to bring you back to that pier.
You always try to scare me with that threat. Is that really what you want?
I just want you to be a good person, Daphne.
If you really want me to be a good person, you should learn to be a good father first.
So how much is it?
Virgie, it's my name.
Okay.
There.
Okay, let's hurry it up. I want to get home.
Good evening, Mother.
Where have you been?
I came from school.
At this time of the night?
Mother, I have classes that extend to the evening.
What a liar. I saw you. You were with that good-for-nothing driver. Who is he? Is he your boyfriend?
Oh, Mother, no.
Huh? Don't you even try to lie to me. He's your boyfriend? Then what will come next? You'll get pregnant? Then you'll marry him? Is that what you want?
Mother, it's not true.
The next time I see you with that boy, that cheap-knee driver, I will throw you out of our home. Now go in. Get inside.
Oh, honey. Oh, welcome home. Why are you crying?
It's Father. He's picking on me again. I just got home and he starts scolding me already.
If it were for my boyfriend Charles, I wouldn't have come home.
Oh, you should be used to your father by now.
At least my stepfather Joel. Even if I wasn't his real daughter, he loved me.
Shh. What do I keep telling you?
That I should forget all about the past?
Exactly. The only thing you should focus on is your future. With Charles.
And that's just one more thing. He's just like father. I feel like he doesn't love me too.
Nonsense. What you should do is get yourself pregnant.
Do you think, Mother, that if Charles gets me pregnant, he'll marry me?
Daphne, come on! I was just joking! Can't you take a joke? Don't you worry, he's losing up. Come here. I miss you so much. My daughter's so pretty.
Ning Ning, why are you taking this abuse?
And where else can I go?
You could leave home, like Mayumi. Or you could just get married to Eric.
If I do that, what will happen to you and Mother?
I'll take care of Mother.
Do you even remember what I promised Father? I said I will take care of you both, right?
But then you have your own life, Ning Ning.
Our family is my life.
Oh, man. You are so out of fashion. Even in soap operas, no one likes Martis IQ anymore.
You shut up. I have my plans. Once I find Mayumi, and when you finally finish your studies, only then will I focus on my life.
You'll be a scraggly old woman by the time that happens. Remember, Eric might get tired of waiting.
Well, if he really loves me, then he'll wait for me.
You shouldn't worry, Ning Ning. I will work really hard to earn enough money. Just so you don't have to work anymore for us.
I'll hold you to that, okay? Promise?
Promise, Ning Ning. Don't worry. Stop all that crying, all right?
Oh, brother. Hey, you should study well.
Of course I will. I'm not just smart, I'm handsome too. I got the last part from you.
So what if you're handsome?
Oh, nothing. I just wanted to point that out. Don't you worry about that, okay?
My Ning Ning?
Yes?
Come here, stay with me and I'll go walk with you.
Mother, where to?
Where else? To your school.
Mother, please, don't do that. I mean, it's embarrassing to my classmates. What will they say? I'm a big girl, but my mother still walks me to school.
Hey, I really don't care what other people say. All I want is to make sure that you are not with that good-for-nothing jeepney driver. Now, come on, come on. Move it.
Oh, no. What are you gonna do?
No way! Go! Move it! Oh, that's okay. He's not good for you.
Hey there, Virgie.
Yes?
Your boss is looking for you.
Why?
I don't know why. He just asked us to find you for him.
Oh, dear. Well, it looks like I won't be able to go with you to school, Ning Ning. Remember, don't you ever ride with that boy again. I don't ever want to see you with that guy. Okay, come on. I'll go now.
Take care now.
Okay, take care of her.
Oh, sure.
Wait for her to
get a ride,
leave
it all up to me.
Yeah.
Me again?
My fault again?